2 days now since what are believed to be the remains of 21-month-old Lonzie Barton were recovered in Bayard. Today, police remain at the scene gathering clues. You're taking a live look along Snyder Street in Bayard right now. Today, we learned how a funeral home in Macclenny will be helping lay Lonzie to rest. Meanwhile, we've learned that a judge has lifted some key restrictions for the prime suspect in the case, Reuben Ebron. In September, a judge ruled that Ebron could have no contact with his parents or his three children while he sits behind bars, but that has now changed. Channel 4's Vic Micolucci will have more on the plans to remember Lonzie, but we begin with Tarek Minor to explain how Ebron has now made contact with his family. Tarek.
And Mary, I spoke with Ruby Ebron's mother, Wanda, who tells me first and foremost, she wants everyone to know that her family is grieving the loss of Lonzie Barton, a child that they remember spending time with at their Northside home. Reuben's mother, Wanda, told me that the family truly thought that Lonzie was still somewhere alive, and even though they are now able to talk to their son, the situation is difficult all the way around. Mrs. Ebron told me that Reuben was allowed to place his first collect phone call to their house last night, and Reuben was able to speak with his three children for the first time in 4 months, those kids living with his parents. Reuben also spoke with his father by phone last night, but his mother, Wanda, wasn't home when he called. So she has yet to talk to him. Wanda says that she cannot get through the day without crying about the loss of Lonzie. We can also confirm that paramedics were called to the Ebron's family house today to treat a woman who had problems breathing. Now, Mrs. Ebron says Reuben's 11-month-old son and other family members will visit him on Monday and sit down with him face-to-face in the Duval County Jail for the first time after learning about Lonzie's remains being found. Wanda Ebron says her heart aches knowing that Lonzie is no longer alive. She also says her attorneys have advised her and her family not to discuss the specifics of the case, which is a request that she says she is honoring. Tom?
Thank you, Tarek. While the remains recovered in Bayard Monday still have not been positively identified as Lonzie Barton's, police strongly believe they are. And now, a funeral home in Macclenny is arranging a memorial and a burial for the boy at no charge. He can be laid to rest once the medical examiner confirms the identity and determines the cause of death. Channel 4's Vic Micolucci spoke exclusively with the funeral director who made this offer. He's joining us live. Vic.
Todd Ferreira says he felt in his heart that this is the right thing to do, but right now he has to wait on the medical examiner first to ID the remains found in Bayard, then to do that autopsy, and then release them if they are Lonzie Barton's. After that, he says he can proceed with the services that this little boy and the community deserve.
I'm there when they're ready.
Todd Ferreira says he's here to serve the family of Lonzie Barton, giving them one less thing to worry about during such a difficult and dramatic time.
What's important to us is Lonzie and his family, and that's what we're committed to.
And giving him a special goodbye.
Absolutely.
One that he deserves.
Absolutely.
He's working with Lonzie's family to plan the funeral and burial. Many of the toddler's loved ones live near the Macclenny funeral home. He says both sides, the mothers and fathers, are involved in the process.
They want what's best as a family.
We're still waiting on a positive ID of the remains found in Bayard and an autopsy. After that, the medical examiner should release them for burial.
The medical examiner is working very hard and diligent to be precise in what they do, and they're not going to rush through anything.
It could take weeks or months. But Ferreira says he and his staff are ready to help however they can. That's why they're offering their services free of charge to Lonzie's family.
It's heart-wrenching to see this happen. And as a person, I'm around death all day long. All day, every day, 24 hours a day. But infants and children that pass away, either from a natural death or unnatural death, just touches me.
Ferreira tells me that he believes the services will be open to the public. That way, all the people in the community that helped pray for him can come in and grieve and get a little bit healing together. As far as the exact day and time, we do not know that yet. We are still waiting to hear back from the medical examiner's office. As soon as we find out those details, of course, I'll pass those along to you. Reporting live in Springfield, I'm Vic Micolucci, Channel 4, the local station.
Thank you, Vic. A child's death touches so many hearts, and that's why a vigil is going to be held tomorrow evening at 6 o'clock at Julington Baptist Church on Snyder Street, not far from where the remains were found. The community is invited to attend. If you cannot make it there, we will be streaming the vigil live on news4jax.com.